I give my life. You are saying it's not your own life. You give to somebody. Somebody can use it. See, let me give an example. That's what is wrong to us many times. Now, if you give me a cloth, you now see me use that cloth for right. How will you feel? You feel sad, Abby. Am I correct? Why will you feel sad? Is it your right? Is it your cloth? That's our problem. You have still claimed that cloth. You have given it out. The reason why you are not because the person uses it for right is because it's your cloth. Ah! See the cloth I give this man, it's no longer your cloth. The moment you give it up, you are giving it to that person. It's not belong to you again. Whatever that person like, he can use it for it because you are giving it out. The same way, when you say you give your life to Jesus, it's no longer your life. Let Jesus use to do whatever you want to use to do. You don't have to tell Jesus, me, I should go to, you call me and come Pastor Jacob together. Or you call Pastor Noah together. Or you call Pastor Dad together. That's my friend, I'm just very sure. And now, this one has already enjoyed ministry. You put them in Lagos. You tell to go back to Adulaju in one place here. No. Lord, let my call also fall. Let my call also be opened up for me in Lagos or in Abuja. I prefer Abuja, oh Lord. Oh, no. You are giving your life to him. It's not belong to you. Paul says, it's no longer I that live. That is to say, if you want this body to suffer, let it suffer for him. If you want this body to enjoy, let it enjoy for him. But I'm going to miss my life here. I told her in Sunday school, many of us, the reason why we come to church is the same goal of Gentile. The same goal of Gentile. I need car, I need money, I need rice, I need the peace, I need to protect, I need it. That's the one brought us to church, a lot of us. We don't have that revelation of the essence of coming to Christ. And in the most of preachers, they are not preaching it unto us. Well, what's the point? Have you been crucified? Hey, he shall be well with you. Amen. If you can say amen 3 times. Oh, they can't get ever so called. I see God lifting up. Amen. That's the reason why we come to church. We miss it, sir. We miss it. Because the life you are living is no longer, it's not supposed to be your life. Paul said, it's no longer I that live, but Christ. Like that, you're my best son. It's because you are the one that living. I will not forgive you. It's because you are the one that living. Me, the daddy Joe, me, the bow. I have your jammy, I have your dog. No, don't you want to pay me? Don't want to only one combine. Once it's of a baba, daddy, you want one more. You want she? Forgive them. They know what they are doing. I want to round up this morning. Let's finish that fast. Now, I have been crucified with Christ. It's no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God. That's where that rhema comes, that revelation comes. How is being crucified? If it is Ashiri, then you come again. He said, by faith, I believe in him. That's why the Bible says, no man can please the Lord without faith. Only people who believe, I didn't believe. Now only that pray, I'm a jammer. Jesus, she didn't hear none yet. I back us, and he's facing it. That's why he said, I'm not walking by sight. We are walking by what? By faith. I can do with lying. That's walking by faith. Sir, it's not possible. You are still living by flesh. You are still living by flesh because flesh will tell you that the impossibility of it, but the spirit will tell you the possibility of it because the spirit has finished it on the cross. Brother and sister, as we examine it, most especially youth, crucify life. Are you ready to live for Christ in your school? In now your workplace? Did you receive that work, that job, or getting that job for yourself or for Christ to be glorified? Because if you are living for Christ in your office, they must see Christ. In your dream, they must see Christ. In the community, they must see Christ. When you speak, they must see Jesus. When you talk, they must see Jesus. When you appear, they must see Jesus. When you sit down, they must see Jesus. And that's why Jesus said in the book of John, chapter 8, verse 12, or 12, verse 8, rather, he said, I am the light of the world. When you go to man tell me, who follow me? No longer walk in life. We have the light of life in there. And when we want to say in the book of Matthew, chapter 5, say, you are the light of the world. Verse 14 says, you are the salt of the world. Brother and sister, you are the representative of Christ. You are not supposed to live for yourself. You are supposed to live for the kingdom that belongs to you. And that kingdom is from above. And you don't know that they die, kingdom come. Not my kingdom, not the kingdom of Satan. When the kingdom of Satan come down into the life of a man, man has been rebuilt against God. And God sent man out, and man was living in the kingdom of Satan. And thick darkness covered the world. But he said, rise, for light has come, and Jesus is that light. And John made us to know, he is the light of all men. Jesus. Are you ready to surrender to him this morning?